Dear student, myself Rajendra Asiri. I am assistant professor in computer science department at Government Bangad PG College, Didwana. In the previous lecture, we started a lecture series on physical storage media devices, right? In physical storage, there are various type of storage devices like cache, main memory, magnetic disk, optical disk, okay? And then after that, we discussed the detailed processing of the magnetic disk, how the detector tracks and sector works, how the disk head used to perform its task with read and write operation. All these concepts we discussed. Then some performance measures like access time, seek time, rotational latency, and data transfer rate. All these concepts we have discussed. And one algorithm on disk arm scheduling, that is elevator algorithm, also we have done. Now in today's lecture, some new concept we are learning. In previous lecture, we started a new concept on RAID, that is redundant array of independent disk. Now continuing that particular lecture, so up to this, in RAID there are various levels. In RAID 0, some different techniques are used, RAID 1, RAID 2, RAID 3. So depending upon the requirement, we can apply a particular RAID disk technique, right? And we can store our data in that particular RAID level. So in RAID level, in today's lecture, we are discussing about RAID level 5. Now this level of redundant array of independent disk is based on a technique called as block interleaved distributed parity technique. Now in this technique, partitions data and parity among all n plus 1 disk, rather than storing data in n disk and parity in one disk. So what will happen? It will partition the data and parity in all the n plus 1 disk. Up to this level, what we were doing in the previous level, we are storing n disk data in different separate disks and parity in one disk. But here, if you see the diagram, suppose here the 5 disks are there, n equal to 5 disks are there. So if you notice that in every disk there is a parity bit, right? So parity bit is added to every disk separately, okay? Now in this example, there are 5 disks. Parity block for nth set of block is stored on disk. On which disk? The formula is modulus formula. N is the number of disk mod 5, because we need to mod by the number of disk plus 1 with the data blocks stored on the other 4 disk, right? So here the technique is block interleaved distributed parity technique. And if you see, there are 5 disks are there and every disk is having a parity bit. So if you see, parity bit 0, parity bit 1, parity bit 2, parity bit 3, and parity bit 5. So in disk 1, the contents are read as P0 is the parity bit, first bit. After that, 4, 8, 12, and 16 is the data bits. Next is the second disk. In second disk, first is the data block, second position is the parity bit, the name is P1. Next, 9, 13, and 17 are the data. So in this manner, we can process the data block and parity bits. Third, if you see the third disk, the data are 1, 5, and then parity bits come, that is P2. And then 14 and 18 are the data. Next is 2, 6, 10, and P3 is the parity bit, and 19 is the data block. Next is 3, 7, 11, 15, and P4 is the parity bit. So in this manner, we can ensure the RAID level and their corresponding parity and data bit combination, right? Next, now RAID level 5 is continue in this slide also. In RAID level 5, higher input rate than input output rate than level 4. It is much, we can say in the performance manner, much simpler than in the form of input output in comparison to level 4. Now in this block writes occur in parallel if the blocks and their parity blocks are on different disk. It subsumes levels 4 It provide same benefit but avoid the bottleneck of parity disk. In level 4, there is some disadvantage or drawback of the parity bit, but here there is no bottleneck of the parity bit. Now next is RAID level 6. In RAID level 6, we are using P plus Q redundancy scheme. Now it is similar to level 5, but it store extra redundant information to guard against multiple disk failure, right? It is better in reliability than level 5 at a higher cost, and it is not used as widely. So if you see in this diagram, there are 6 disks and every disk is associated with a parity bit. So here in this diagram, RAID 6, there are P plus Q redundancy bits are applied, right? Next is choice of RAID level. Up to this point, we discussed about 7 levels of RAID, starting from RAID 0, RAID 1, RAID 2, RAID 3, RAID 4, RAID 5 and RAID 6. Every RAID level is associated with different bit level, bit mapping. Someone is associated with block level, someone is with the parity block interlude technique and so on. Okay, so which RAID level we should proceed, it depends upon some factor. So factor in choosing a RAID level, what type of factor we need to consider while finalizing or going to a particular RAID level. So first is monetary cost. Definitely we need to see the cost of that particular RAID level in order to use that particular RAID. Next is performance, the number of input and output operation per second and bandwidth during normal operation is very important in order to decide a particular RAID level. Next is performance during failure. Next, performance during rebuild of failed task. It include time taken to rebuild a failed task. Now RAID 0 is used only when data safety is not permanent. Example, data can be recovered quickly from other sources, right? Level 2 and level 4 never used since they are subsumed by 3 and 5. Level 3 is not used anymore since bit stripping forces single block reads to access all the disks. Now it is wasting disk arm movement, which block stripping or level 5 avoid, right? Level 6 is rarely used since level 1 and level 5 offer adequate safety for almost all applications. So level 6 is rarely used. So computation is between 1 and 5. So if you see this classification or this analysis, then you will come to know that level 1 and level 5 is the most popular among the RAID level. Level 6 rarely used. RAID 3 is also rarely used because it is based on bit stripping technique. Okay, and in this block reads to access all the disk, and it is wasting the disk arm movement, which block stripping. Okay, now next is choice of RAID level continues. In level 1, it provide much better write performance than level 5. Okay, now we are comparing between level 1 and level 5. In the previous slide, we compared all the levels and we reach a decision that level 5 and level 1 is much better than all the remaining level. Now level 1 and level 5 comparison. So level 1 provide much better write performance than level 5. Level 5 require at least 2 block read and 2 block write to write a single block, whereas level 1 only require 2 block write. Okay, next is level 1 preferred for high update environment such as log disk. Okay, next is level 1 had higher storage cost than level 5. Clear? Disk drive capacity increasing rapidly, like 50% per year. Disk drive capacity keep on increasing every year, all of you know already, whereas disk access time have decreased much lesser, up to by 3 in 10 years. So input output requirement have increased greatly, example for web server, right? Now when enough disks have been bought to satisfy required rate of input output, they often have spare storage capacity. So there is often no extra monetary cost for the level 1. So it means level 1 is much better. Now level 5 is preferred for the application with low update rate and large amount of data. If we want to proceed for large amount of data and there is a requirement of low update rate, then we should proceed for the level 5, else we should go for the level 1. Now there are some hardware issue in RAD. RAD implementation done entirely in software with no special hardware support. But in hardware RAD, what happened? RAD implementations with special hardware. Okay, it use non-volatile RAM to record writes that are being executed. Right, now here some precautions we need to be aware about that. The first is power failure during write can result in corrupted disk. Right, example, failure after writing one block but before writing the second in a mirrored system. Such corrupted data must be detected when power is restored. Okay, next, recovery from corruption is similar to recovery from failed disk. Now non-volatile RAM help to efficiently detected potentially corrupted blocks. Otherwise all blocks of disk must be read and compared with mirror or parity block. Right, so these all the points are about hardware RAD. Next is hardware issues. In hardware, hot swapping is the first concept. It means the replacement of disk while system is running without power down is called as hot swapping. It is supported by some hardware RAD system. Now it reduces time to recovery and improve the availability in great extent. Many system maintain spare disks which are kept online and used as replacement for failed disk immediately on detection of failure. It reduces time to recovery greatly. Many hardware RAD system ensure that a single point of failure will not stop the functioning of the system by using some technique, redundant power supply with battery backup or multiple controllers and multiple interconnections to guard against controller and interconnection failure. Optical disk. In optical disk, compact disk read only memory is used, which is CD-ROM. In this removable disk, and the size is up to 640 MB per disk is used. Seek time is about 100 milliseconds and optical read head is heavier and slower. Next is higher latency, up to 3000 round per minute and lower data transfer rate compared to magnetic disk. So next is digital video disk, that is DVD. In DVD, we can DVD 5, it hold 4.7 GB of the storage, and DVD 9 can hold up to 8.5 GB of storage. DVD 10 and DVD 18 are double-sided format with capacity very large 9.4 GB and 17 GB. It is having slow seek time. Okay, for same region as the CD-ROM. Seek time is very slow. Why? Because optical read head is heavier and slower. The reason is why seek time is slow, because optical read head is heavier and slower. Next is it record once versions are popular. Data can only be written once and cannot be erased. It is having high capacity and long lifetime, and it is used for archival storage. It is multi-write versions like CD, RW, DVD, RW, DVD plus RW and so on. Right? Next is magnetic tape. It hold large volume of data and provide high transfer rate, like few GB for DAT. DAT means digital audio tape format, 10 to 40 GB with DLT, that is digital linear tape format, and 100 GB with Ultrium format. Okay, 330 GB with MPEX helical scan format. So various formats are available in magnetic tape, and depending on that, different storage capacity are there. Currently, the cheapest storage medium is magnetic tapes. Tapes are cheap, but cost of drives is very, very high. Very slow access time in comparison to magnetic disc and optical disc. It is limited to sequential access only. So these are the limitations. And tape jukeboxes used for very, very large capacity storage up to terabytes to petabyte. Petabyte means 10 raised to 15 byte order. Okay, so that's all from this lecture. In next lecture, some new exciting concept about storage devices. Thank you.